Welcome to this Axure tutorial. Today we're going to look at how to display dynamic content within an Axure prototype. For this example, we're going to assume that this text contains a first description and then some details that you may or may not want to read before clicking on either confirm or back. I added this little text here, a label that just says view details, and this is going to trigger our interactions. So what we want is these two widgets to disappear and appear based on what I click here. So the interaction itself will be triggered on click, and then what I want to do is to toggle the visibility. So when I click once, the text appears. When I click another time on the same place, then the text disappears. But first I need to name my text fields. It's very important to name all the widgets that you're using and interacting with. First, because they'll be a lot easier to find when you're actually creating the interactions. And second, if someone else has to work on your prototype or you need to make changes after a month, you probably will have forgotten how it worked and you'll be happy that you named everything and that you don't have to do any guesswork. And that's it, so let's have a look at what it does. Now I click on view details, it hides them first and then it shows them again. So what I want is that I want it to be hidden first. So I'll select these, right click and set hidden. You can also do that in the style. You have a small checkbox here, which basically does the same thing. And now I want this to be here by default. But now if I just do it like this, the text will appear on top. So just for the sake of it, I'll show you what it looks like. See, now it appears first, but then the rest doesn't move. And we want the buttons to move down. So back in the day, what we would have done is to use the move, then select the buttons here and move them by the same height as both of my widgets here. But since Axure 7, there's a much easier way to do this. You just go to your interaction here, and then you can push pull widgets. So if you just check this box, and this means it will push all widgets that are below the text by the height of the thing you're displaying. So you have to do it on both for it to work properly. I'll just leave the default setting, no animations. Let's have a look at what this does. Yay! Now you notice that the back button here is moving up. It doesn't stay aligned with the confirm button. That's because the push-pull interaction is based on the size of the widget. So let's say my text, not this one, this text here is only half the width and it isn't above the back button. It will be even worse. Now the back button will not move at all, because it only pushes the stuff that's below the widget that appears and disappears. So that means that for the back button to move properly, you also need the label to be all the width. And now it should be flawless. Yeah, that's what you want. Now there's another way of doing this. So I'm just going to remove the interaction here briefly. Set this visible. Okay. This interaction also works on groups. So if I press Command G, it will group these two widgets together. I'll name this group Details. And then when I add the toggle visibility interaction now, I can just select details here, push and pull widgets, and now it will work on the size of the group and only have to do the interaction once. Now you can add some fancy animations, like for example, since the interaction is above, let's say I want the content to, let's say, slide down from the top as if it appears, and then when it's hiding, I want it to slide back up. You can also have an animation for the stuff that's moving below. So let's add a bounce animation just to see what it looks like. You can play around that and make some really cool stuff with it. So now here is my new version. It will hide it first. And as you see, animations are really nice, and sometimes they're important to help the user understand the interaction, but don't abuse them. It's usually not the point, especially in early wireframes. Another way to do this, showing and hiding some detailed text, is instead of grouping them, so I'll go Command-Shift-G to ungroup. You can also do this by converting something to a dynamic panel. I'll just name it Details Panel. You can do exactly the same thing. Instead of showing and hiding the group, you can show and hide the panel. You can also add an empty state to the panel. So here you have one content of your panel, which is the details. The second I'll just leave empty. And then you can say fit to content. So this means that when a panel is empty, the dynamic panel will take up really little space. And instead of show hide, I'm going to set the panel to a different state. So I'll remove this, set panel details to state next. So first time it will set it to the empty state. And then when I wrap from first to last and from last to first, then the second time I click, it will show the content again. Hide the content, show the content, hide the content, show the content. You can also add animations. We'll not do it right now. And you can also push and pull widgets, which will only work because our panel will change in size. So let's try this. Does exactly the same thing, except here I'm not using show and hide. So these are three ways of doing the same thing that might come in use for different kind of situations. Grouping stuff will be very useful if you have a lot of items that are separate widgets but that you want to all show and hide at the same time. It will make things a lot easier. You can directly act on the widgets like we did here when you don't have that many of them, but be aware that the more widgets there are, the more there's chances that you'll make a mistake and that something will go wrong. Then you'll have to debug it. Using dynamic panels was the only way to achieve this in Axure 6 and less. It's not really a best practice anymore, and it's best to hide the whole panel rather than to use an empty state in general, but still it's nice to know that the option exists. And that's it for today. Hope you enjoyed it and practice Axure.